This one's testing the air.
Yeah, well, we've got onto this property and been looking around for a day or so, and it was early in the morning. We were walking along and we'd seen a few animals, and we happened to spot this beautiful 32-inch stag in hard velvet, and Daryl said I'd take it. He was going to take the shot. And
nice tops, nice inners.
Oh, yeah. Strong all round head.
You reckon go 200?
No, he won't go 200 because he carries the inners high.
Oh, yeah.
But he will go in 180. He's a trophy class animal, record class animal.
Good shot.
He's a very, very old animal because his pedicles are shrunk right down and they're as heavy as his coronets. So it's probably one of the last good heads that he'll shoot.
Yeah, it must have been like that. Oh, yeah, well, I suppose so.
The patient hunter gets his quarry right.
Been using sticks,
he's got a screen on.
Been using sticky.
He's got the swollen neck on him.
Beautiful.
He's an old animal. He's going on, you know, 11-year-old, that sort of thing. It's the last decent that he's thrown. He would have been a screaming head last year.
Fuck, his teeth are in good neck, eh?
Are they?
Well, it's front one, though.
I'll get some photos, eh?
Good light, too, for photos.
Take a photo of that one.
Yeah, he's an old one. As soon as you see the pedicles like that, you know. What do you reckon, Daryl? 31?
What was it, Nick?
Yeah, he was long.
32.
Beautiful head, mate.
32 by about 20, what, 27 wide?
Yeah.
26 and a half, yeah. Big strong inners, he's got bloody 8 inches on that one. Yeah, nearly 8 inches there and 6.5 there. Yeah, he's easily in the 185s. Just a little bit going back on his brow tines.
Yeah.
That's where they pick him up on the brows, don't they? The length on the brows.
He still looks
all
nice.
All around, yeah. What a nice head.
Brilliant.
Thanks for bloody being patient.
If you ever had the desire to ever go to North Queensland hunting the most beautiful Asiatic deer in Australia, the Chital deer, Axis Axis, this piece of footage would probably be beneficial for you to look at if you're ever looking for a trophy animal.
Yeah, he'd have to go 30, Reg.
Chital deer are gregarious by nature. They're always on the alert, or there's always one or two, maybe more, on the alert. Getting close to them is very difficult. As I say, they've got exceptionally good eyesight, hearing, smell, and this bit of footage is probably good to look at just to give you an indication what what you need to look at for a good trophy animal. As I said, trophy animals, they're different in antler shape, and you can get what I'd probably love the most is the hourglass look, and then you got this virtually the magnificent straight beam ones with massive tops. And what you look at is the tops having the inner tines down low, and then looking for those massive brow tines. With Chital there, they fight a fair bit. Not that you see them marked up that much, but they break they can break off the tine easily. They're not as heavy in the beams as like Samba or a lot of the other deer. So it's very hard. You might see a magnificent animal with a broken top or a broken brow, but this bit of footage is probably what you need to look at if you're ever looking to be selective of what type of trophy animal you want to take when if you ever go up there. Things you need to take is a good set of binoculars, set of gaiters. Clothing is quite durable, like not too hot, because it's quite warm up there. Can get any, especially around July, it's not so humid, but it gets quite warm. So you need to take clothing that'll wick away sweat and stuff like that. As I say, the deer have exceptionally good smell and hearing, and their eyesight, as I said, they're spot on. Fucking hell. The last couple of days, I was fortunate enough to see an animal that I wanted to put a hunt on, and man behind the camera, so he filmed me putting a hunt on a nice 30-inch head that I always wanted, a real chocolate caped animal. And
down. Beautiful. Good job, Reg.
Hey. Congratulations, Reg. It's been a top trip hunting with Daryl, Carl and Reg Gordon, the Aspen father and son team from New Zealand. Everyone took trophy class animals. Two record class animals and a trophy class animal here that Reg took. Last evening of the hunt, took some spectacular video footage, as you probably noticed over the hunt.
Yeah, did you go with the kill shot? Did you get it?
Yeah, I think I got it. Yeah, it's a fair way away. Yeah, it's hard to get up on these buggers. Yeah. With so many deer around.
We're lucky with young fellas here. Carl did it. Yeah, I was quite in shock with Carl's.
It's just been a really successful hunt all round.
Is he going to have a full rut stag down the east and all go down well?
Well, I think so. Wash the dust down.
Yeah.
Plenty of bull dust, plenty of bullshit.
We'll need to put some antiseptic on my knees when we're all yeah. Trying to get that close to those video those deer. There's some nice stags amongst them too, but this is one I sort of wanted. You know, I wanted a rut stag, I think I wanted a velvet.
Gee, there was some good stags in Melbourne. Yeah, even in June, July, you can't really pick them up. But the charter stags, chill bird. And so I had read about the Indian herd as well. There's no specific rut time.
I far enjoyed it really. It's like it's a bit different to hunting sand, but they're a challenge because they've got great eyesight and they pick up on anything, you know. So they're not an easy deer to hunt, really. They're hard deer to hunt, especially if they've been hunting.
Each property is different yeah. hunting method. This property is mainly prairie country, very open, so it's hard to get it pretty close. Yeah. Your shots average that 200 metres.
I noticed that, like you drive the car, you can see the car, but they've got a great nose. Plus they're pretty adherent.
Yeah, Samba's a rugged, respected animal and the chital are the most pretty of the species. Thanks for coming along, Richard.
Congratulations.
Well, we've been doing some hunting on several properties by now and we'll see some really good chital stags, but we decided Carl would take this animal. It was, and Nick was pretty spot on. He said about 28 inch velvet head, had beautiful tops and brows, and I managed to be able to capture the hunt on film. The boys actually stalked as close as they could to this beautiful animal without disturbing them. You know, it was pretty hard. They only needed the wind to change and they probably would have went. But Carl shot his first chital. This was 15 years ago. So now he's a young man that's probably married and got kids, but he has
roughly
fond
lifelong
memories of his hunt in Queensland with Nick.
And
yeah, it was great. It was great to spend time with these guys. It was like if you knew them for 30 years, you know, they had the same values for hunting, the connection that hunters seem to have.
I suppose he's probably about a kilometre away from the main herd, from all the does that live in the area. So another month and he would have been in full rut, hanging around with all the does. What do you have, probably 15 other young stags with him? A dozen to 15?
A characteristic with chital, that they in bachelor herds?
Yeah, you see them in bachelor herds in all antler development stages, from soft velvet to hard velvet to post-rut stags, pre-rut stags. They tend to stick together when they're not in rut,
mm-hmm.
Get away from the girls.
I noticed one characteristic thing when they're in it, like a bachelor group, they always seem to have one cockatooing or, you know, just on alert,
yeah.
While the others feed.
Yep.
They take it in turns.
Even when they're bedded up, you notice when they're bedded up, they'll bed up so that they've got a 360 degree view of any danger. There's always a stag that, or even if there are does there, there'll always be one that won't be sleeping looking around.
Movement seems to be their thing. They seem to if you're moving a little bit quick or you just get into the sunlight, they're on right onto you, aren't they?
It doesn't matter how much camouflage you drape over yourself, if you're moving when they're watching, you've pretty much they'll go. Yeah, movement is their main. They pick up movement.
They have very good eyes, don't they?
Yeah, good eyes, excellent smell, excellent hearing, like Samba.
Yep.
being on the tigers, menu, they've got to stay alert. Got to have acute senses, yeah. And they don't smell even when they're in full rut. Their pre-orbit glands do swell, but they don't smell like other deer. They don't urinate over themselves and they don't wallow.
Yeah, very clean deer, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah, they're meticulous groomers. They're always grooming themselves.
Where you like
your... Very rarely you'll find a chital stag or a chital deer with ticks on it.
Mm.
It's got to be right at the end of the year that you'll only find a few ticks on them. When they're suffering a little bit from dry time. But otherwise they're a very clean animal. Just like the hog deer and Samba, yeah.
You notice the rifle. That's a blazer. Caliber?
270.
270. Did the job.
That's taken a few fine trophies, hasn't it, Daryl?
Yeah.
They're a fine trophy hunting rifle, being compact.
What distance do you reckon Carl took the shot from?
We had a look with the rangefinder at one point there. It was 170. We closed the gap in...
205,
and we closed the gap to 170.
Yeah.
And they moved off a little bit. We closed the gap to 150, so it was roughly 150-metre shot.
Yeah.
Very deceptive when you're videoing from behind. It makes the hunter look like he's only 50 metres away.
Yeah. Well, I've got that on video, so it'll be quite interesting to have a look at that, to review it and see what it looks like.
Yeah. Yeah, it turned out perfect. Good stalk. Half an hour of crawling. We almost blew it there at one point. One of the other young stags barked. Hard to get three hunters up close to a chital deer, especially when there's so many eyes looking at you.
What do you reckon, Carl? We need a word from you, mate. You know, you're a bit shy.
Pretty wrapped with it all.
Good stuff.
Quite a good stalk. Had a lot of fun with it.
Yeah, good stuff.
Crawling in that. And I'm pretty impressed with my shot.
Was a good shot.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
And then the other thing is you can review it when you get about my age, show your kids and that, and say, well, this is what I used to do when I was a young fella.
Yeah.
Here's one I didn't miss. You might notice in the camera there that the projectile's lodged just under the skin. It was shot from the other side, perfect heart shot, and it's lodged just under the skin there, 130 grain SST.
Beautiful markings. Notice in velvet, they don't have the real chocolatey type...
Yeah, with chital deer, it seems to be in their pigmentation, just like humans. Some humans are brown-haired, some people are blonde-haired. Some velvet stags have a richer, chocolatier coat, and some stags, even if they're in full rut, they only tend to darken up on the neck and the shoulder.
A bit like hog deer, have got the same. They've got like a dark, chocolatey chest.
Yeah, a lot of it's to do with the genetics. Yeah, some stags are genetically an orangier colour, and they seem to just darken up in the shoulder when they rut. But we've seen stags that are just a chocolatey colour, even if they're in velvet.
Run on. Gallop. Excellent shot, Steve. Run on. Gallop. Excellent shot, Steve.
opposed to use a nice sharp knife, makes your job easier. Now cut it roughly 8 to 10 inches behind the shoulder for a shoulder mount. There are a few different methods. You can either cut up the back and up the back of the foreleg. I use the booting method, where you just pull them off as a sock. Makes the taxidermist job a bit easier, less stitching. So that'll stay one piece, it doesn't have to stitch it up the back there. So you'd cut right around there. And if you do put a nick in the cape, well, it's not the end of the world. It just makes the taxidermist work a little bit harder.
Good shot.
Thank you.
Beautiful stag. Nice and fat, right in season, nice and thick neck. How many does did you have, Al?
Well, we had about a good number of 10.
Yeah, enough, eh? Yep. 10 does you had. Good shooting, Al. Good stalk too. Pick his head up for us. Nice and wide. Look at that. Beautiful.
That's shooting. The thistles in your boots, mate. Beautiful. Good looking animal. Thanks, Nick. You produced the goods.
This is you produced it, mate. You did the hunting and shooting. I just showed you where it was.
Well, you done that well.
Yeah. What did you shoot him with, Al?
I was using the Winchester factory loads, 150 grain.
Yeah.
With the CMC Mountaineer. 300 Winchester Magnum.
What a way to christen a rifle, huh?
It's not bad at all. Purpose built. It's been 2 years in the process, but we finally got one.
Yeah. This is where he fell over, right where he stood. We were somewhere over on one of them trees over there. Something down there. We'll have a look for his duck then.
Thank you. couple of spikers in the back having a bit of a go.
Yeah. That spiker and that stag.
No chance, Spikey. Yeah. He's got no chance, that Spikey.
How far do you reckon the shot was when you shot him?
50 at the most.
50 at the most. Beautiful time of the year, everything's green. And that's what grows heads like that.
Just going to take a few measurements of the stag that Steve just shot. What do you reckon, Steve?
30 and a half.
How do you feel about 32 and a half?
Excellent.
32 and a half by...
What have we got for width?
27? 21 and a half. 21 and... Well, yeah, 5/8. Beautiful stag. He'd score roughly top 10. Top 10 trophies in Australia. Beautiful animal. Congratulations, Steve.
Thanks very much. He's roughly 33 inches long, about 27 wide. Probably go top 5 in Australia. An old mate over there, Nick from MC Trophy Hunting, done the trick.
You did the trick, mate. Good hunting. Good shooting. Looks like he's been wallowing and rubbing. Good shot, Pete.
Thanks, mate. This a young one. Just...
There's points everywhere.
Fuck, I'm shaking now. Recording all?
First deer he's ever shot.
Best one ever.
What a way to start the collection. Beautiful. One shot kills. Stalked up to him. This is the stag that I shot over here. Lift his head up for me, please. This is a non-typical stag. I didn't shoot him for his length, I shot him because he's throwing extra points and